play free fantasy football for the big game for your shot at the $1 million top prize. Welcome back to First Things First. We are now joined by former NFL head coach Eric Mangini. Hey, coach, thanks for being with us.
Good to be here. Good to see you.
Good to see you as always, coach.
I thought you were, it looked like you wanted to say something.
He did. Yeah, he said good to see you.
Oh, that was it. Okay, good. Well done then.
I totally wanted to say that.
Here we go. Coach, you're a Wesleyan guy, right? Let's do some math. If you added up the ages of Sean McVay and Jared Goff, you're still 9 years shy of Bill Belichick. All right, I actually did the math for you, Binghamton girl. It's pretty impressive that the young Rams are sharing this big stage with such a dynastic Patriots team. And with a win, McVay and Goff would, in fact, be the youngest duo to ever win a Super Bowl. All right, coach, what do the Rams need to do if they're going to pull this off?
Yeah, from an age perspective, Bill's been coaching for 43 years, and Sean's only been alive for 33 years, so a pretty big mismatch there. To me, and it's hard to look at this as an upset as well. I know the Patriots are a little bit favored, but
tiny.
The Rams during the whole course of the season versus, so that I don't see it that way. But what they do need to do to win the game, the first thing is they can't have self-inflicted wounds. That's the first thing they can't have. And I don't mean the tip ball that's an interception. I mean forcing the throw into coverage, making pressing on offense and making a decision that leads to a turnover, and then defensively, not getting lined up in the right spot. You saw it some with San Diego and Kansas City, being able to communicate the motions and the stacked wide receivers, not hitting each other and knocking each other off on crossing routes. So those self-inflicted lining up off sides, all those things, that's the first level. The second level is they have to do something that New England hasn't seen. New England is constantly putting the pressure on the other team to adjust to them. Take that power back. Force New England to adjust to something you do. And especially offensively, you control everything that happens. You control the personnel group, the shifts, the motions. Give them something that they have to go to the sideline and talk about. And the same thing defensively. Don't line up in the spots that give information. And the last thing I'd say is, all these mercenaries that came in, all these high-paid guys that came in, all these stars that were traded for, they need to be stars. They need to live up to the billing that they had. And this is why they were brought there. This is their moment to vindicate, where they were drafted and all the things that go with that. So those stars need to be stars in this moment.
So I want to give you a very specific idea and see what you think of it. So the Rams, we know this year, basically ran everything out of 11 personnel, where they had one running back, one tight end, three wide receivers on the field. The Patriots' pass defense was top three in the NFL when facing 11 personnel. The Ringer had this stat. I thought it was great. But when facing 12 personnel, so one running back, two tight end, they were bottom six in the league. They, for some reason or another, did not specifically do well against personnel package that the Rams very rarely run. Is that the type of thing you're talking about? Looking at things that you don't really have a lot of examples on tape of doing, which is have two tight ends on the field, that also matches up with something the Patriots struggle against, and try to, the week of or in the last week and a half, install more plays like that so it catches the Patriots off guard a little bit.
Well, you can try to get it done with a personnel group, but are there tight ends really traditional tight ends? So you look at Gerald Everett, he's a thinner guy,
borderline. Not afraid of him.
Yeah, it's borderline 11 personnel when he's in the game. And it also depends on how New England views your personnel group.
Will they change as well?
Or right. Will you be able to get them into a group that you want them to with
with your
bunch of players?
Yep.
To me, it's more about shifts, motions, stacks, bunches. All those things. I love the fact that the Rams go up in quick count. That, to me, that's hard defensively because it forces you to move off of disguise early.
Well, typically, Nick, you're 12 personnel. What it does to the defense is you don't really have a strong side. You put the tight end on both sides, ball's in the middle of the field. That's the reason why these offenses are very, very effective against a defense that's going to play multiples like New England. I like the fact that we're going to change personnel, but we're also going to change what we did. I'm going to take it to another level.
Okay.
12 personnel, two tight ends on the field. Also, I'm going in shotgun. They don't do a lot of running the football from shotgun. When Jared Goff's in the shotgun, they throw the ball an awful lot. So 12 personnel, they're thinking run. I put him in the shotgun where they're thinking, pass. So now I put a couple of your components in one equation. And then I run Todd Gurley. Because Todd Gurley, besides being multiple, Todd Gurley's got to get 20 touches. The Rams aren't going to win this game. And to me, they don't have to be in the traditional tailback spot. I would line him up out wide. Put him in motion. You know what? Run him on a speed sweep. New England hates. Now, what they do a great job with leverage. They do not want you to get around the outside. So what about put your best running back in a wide receiver spot and speed him sweep go. Him on the outside? And one thing I know with Bill Belichick, what he tries to do, Mangini talks about it all the time, he wants to fight in the phone booth. This has to be the most physical game that the Rams have played all season. They got a better offensive line. I go with two tight ends in the game. I believe that they're bigger and stronger than New England's interior. I believe they can have a huge advantage there. And on the defensive side, man, you got to tackle in space. The way they beat the Rams, the greatest show on turf, was bumping them and tackling. The Rams have to be able to do that to New England. Gronk, Edelman, James White, no matter when they get the football, you need them to be down within 2 to 3 yards. That's the way the Rams, I believe, Nick, having a couple components of what you like and what coach like, throw that at the Patriots.
The other thing that I like that the Rams do consistently is they run move the pocket play, so a boot or a dash, to the offense's left. And typically that doesn't happen.
And that's hard for a right-handed quarterback, typically.
Well, it's hard for a right-handed quarterback, but it's also hard for a right-handed defense. You're used to seeing those plays over and over come to your defense's left.
Right.
So you have this, you call it a robot reaction. There's robot reactions to those routes because they're so traditional.
They only have so many combinations. You can route read them. When he rolls out to the right, the middle linebacker turns and waits for the crossing.
Yeah, it's like a click whirl reaction to the guys in your program. Now, when it goes the other way, you're not used to fitting those routes with that group of personnel. So you may do 10 reps of boots to your left versus 1 or 2 reps of boots to your right. And the Rams throughout the year have done a good job of pressuring teams on that side of the ball.
Coach, we started the segment talking about age. You mentioned the difference between where Belichick is and where McVay is. Does age even matter? Is there any part of the Patriots game plan that's going to be exposing Goff and McVay for their lack of experience in this game more than any other?
I mean, I think Goff more than McVay. I think they are going to try to exploit the lack of NFL football and high leverage football Goff's played. Like, that is an enormous part of trying to show them things that will surprise him, by doing things similar things to what they know what the Rams want to do. And one of the reasons Belichick has teams have won 18 straight games against quarterbacks 25 and under is young quarterbacks, even really good young quarterbacks. They played the best young quarterback last week, and they just said, hey, the thing that you've had the most success with, Tyreek Hill, we're taking it away. And it took him 2 quarters and a halftime meeting to adjust to figure out how to deal with that. I think they can exploit Goff's lack of experience far better than Sean McVay's.
Yeah, the experience part is a big component of this.
Yes.
And look, I've been in plenty of meetings with Bill where he'll reference things from, you know, 1985 or going against this system over time. I remember in the Philadelphia Super Bowl, we busted out the wide tackle six, which is an old school defensive formation that we really hadn't played, nobody had played in years and years, but it was good for that, what they were doing in the running game, and they had no idea what we're in. So there's some things that you can draw on historically just because of that wealth of experience, and they have that experience together.
Right.
So they're talking the same language.
Good insight, Coach. Thanks, stick around. Coming up, should the Patriots give Tom Brady a contract extension? That's next on First Things First.
I believe Sean McVay has more problems with